The topic in this video is the cable inlets we are using for our KPL, KPG, KWM, KSE and KSN pumps. The agenda is the cable inlet design, updates that has been done to the cable inlet, and how to service and upgrading the cable inlets. This is the standard cable inlet with the smallest version here and the biggest version here. It consists of a stainless steel housing, a lower thrust washer, two rubber bushings, an upper thrust washer, a cable gland, two component epoxy filling, and an O-ring. The cable gland is compressing the rubber bushings between the two thrust washers and thereby making a sealing between the cable and the stainless steel housing. The two component epoxy filling is making an additional sealing in case the rubber surface of the cables has been scratched and water is entering into the cable. The complete cable inlet unit is installed onto the pump, and the sealing between the cable inlet unit and the pump is taken care of by an O-ring. In October 2019, epoxy filling were added to both the power cable inlet and the sensor cable inlet as an additional sealing. Servicing and upgrading. For those of you who has changed cables on the bigger pumps, you know that it takes quite a lot of force to disassemble the cable glands from the cable inlets. To make it a bit easier, a fixation tool has been made, which make it possible to fixate the cable inlets in a firm grip, for instance in a vise. The tool is capable of handling all the sizes of cable inlets which we are using in these pumps. On the service portal, it is possible to download the drawings for the tool or to download a step file which can be sent to a local machining company for producing the tool. The tool is not on any Grundfos stock. Facing a pump with moisture or water inside the motor top, we recommend you to shorten the cable or put in a new cable and use the two component epoxy to fill in the cable inlet afterwards. In factory, we are using the following Korean type of epoxy, but it is also possible to use other types as long as they are suited for the purpose. As service part, Grundfos offers the below type, which is easy to use, and a link to the datasheet can be found in the below comment. Epoxy for electrical purposes has dielectric properties, for example up to 1 kilovolt or up to 6 or 10 kilovolt. In this design, we are not utilizing the dielectric properties as they are taken care of by the insulation around the cords in the cable. Dismantling the cable inlets with a two-component epoxy requires the same force as without epoxy, but other actions need to be taken. Either the cables has to be turned together with the cable gland, or the cables needs to be cut outside the cable inlet, or the epoxy can be heated up using an electrical heat gun, and thereby it will be soft, which make it possible to turn the cable gland without turning or cutting the cables.